Everyone, in this video, I'm going to go over how to create dot density maps in R using census data. So I'm going to basically walk through an R script that I wrote, and I already put the R script in an R pubs document, so I will put a link to that in the description box below. And this video is focusing on how to create dot density maps using census data, and I'm going to show two examples of different dot density maps. So I have the two examples shown here. So, if you're not familiar with dot density maps, basically they are thematic maps used to visualize geographic distributions of a variable, and they're very commonly used in kind of like demographic work to show racial heterogeneity in a neighborhood or a certain geographic area. So, that's the type of plots that I'm going to show as my examples. So, for example, this, and I'm going to talk about it more in the video, this is the state of Hawaii, and then I'm showing the racial and ethnic heterogeneity. So basically, the dots represent geographic distributions of Asian, Black, Hispanic, and White people. So let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. I'm going to assume that you have already installed these five packages to follow along with my code. So the way we're going to access census data in R is through an R package called tidycensus. Then we're just going to load in tidyverse to use basic code for data manipulation. And then these three packages are used for viewing and interacting with thematic maps. So we have the package tmap, mapview, and Tigris. So I'm just going to run these lines of code to load in all of these R packages. So in the next part of the script, I commented it out, but if this is your first time using tidycensus, the way tidycensus works is it accesses data sets from the official US Census Bureau API. So I put a link to getting the API key that you're going to need in order to access the data from the API. So you have to basically sign up one time to get an API key, and then you have to run this line of code one time. So census underscore API underscore key, you put in the API key that they give you, and if you put install equals true, then if you're running this code on a local machine, it will remember your API, so you only have to run this line of code one time. In my case, I've already used tidycensus before, so I'm just going to comment this out and not run this line of code. And then for the next line of code, this is just saying what type of plot we want to show using the R package tmap, which stands for thematic map. So it can show you either an interactive plot where you can like hover and click on different parts of a map, in which case you want to have tmap underscore mode be inserted with the word view. But in my case, for this R demo, I just want to show static maps that are basically like JPEGs, and so I'm going to put tmap underscore mode and then put the word plot. The next line of code is going to run for the first example of the dot density map, which is to show the racial ethnic heterogeneity of Miami-Dade County, which is the southeastmost county in Florida. And so in South Florida, there are a lot of Latino immigrants. And so, as expected, when I plotted this map earlier, you see a lot of green dots in Southeast Florida. And this represents a large population of Hispanic people living in that county. So in order to create the dot density map, first we're just going to get the data from tidycensus. To do that, I'm going to get census data from Miami-Dade County using the 2020 decennial census. So the code for running that through tidycensus is called get underscore decennial. So that means you're going to access data from the decennial census. For geography, you put in the level of geography that you want. So in this first example, I want a county, and then I'm going to specify the county using state and county. So I'm giving the name of the county that I want, which is Miami-Dade, and then I'm letting tidycensus know that the state that that county is found in is Florida. In the next part of the code, I need to let tidycensus know what variables I want to pull from. So I want the racial and ethnic counts from Miami-Dade County. Those are their own variables, Hispanic, White, Black, and Asian. So those have their own tables, and I need to pass that in as variables to get decennial. So I do that in this line of code. Then I have to let tidycensus know what year I want for the decennial census. So they release data in 2010, 2000, and also 2020. So if I want the most recently released data, I'm going to put year equal to 2020. And I'm going to put geometry equal to to get the coordinate information and the shapefile information for this data as well, because I want to plot a dot density map. So I'm going to run this line of code that's actually going to give me the table data for Miami-Dade, and that takes a minute to run. Once that is done, I then have a data table in the right-hand side, which has the geographic information and also the tabulated information of counts for the racial and ethnic makeup of Miami-Dade County. This next line of code is going to convert the data from tabular form to dot form so I can then plot it. And in particular, for these lines of code, the only thing you might want to change is this line, which tells you how many people should one dot represent. In the dot density maps that I plotted, I'm saying that one dot is equal to 2,000 people. And so that's why I have 2,000 here. So I'm going to run these lines of code. Then I'm going to put background tracks equal to the race variable that I created earlier. And then this line of code will actually plot the dot density map. This is pulling from functions from the tmapr package. So we have to pass in the background tracks. We have to pass in md underscore dots, which is what we use to create the dots that are going to be plotted. And then you can play around with the different ways of displaying and writing out titles and things for the plot. So for example, I have a title that says one dot is equal to 2,000 people, and the scale also just affects how big you want the text to be. So I'm going to run these lines of code, and that produces the dot density map. This is one example where it just shows the county for Miami-Dade as part of Florida, because that was what was requested. And so in the next example, I'm just going to show a different level of geography, and I'm going to do basically the same thing, try to pull the same type of information, but this time plot it for the entire state of Hawaii. In this case, the level of geography is going to be equal to state, and then I just have to pass in the state that I want. The table variable names are going to be the same, and I'm going to also pull from the same year 2020. And again, I still want the geometry information for plotting. For Hawaii, since it is a group of a bunch of small islands that are separated from each other, I also added this line of code at the end, which is shift geometry. This comes from the R package Tigris, and it will improve the appearance of Hawaii. So you can also do this, for example, if you want to plot the entire United States and include Alaska and Hawaii, you're going to want to usually shift the geometry of Alaska and Hawaii to appear closer together than it actually is in the true geometry. So this does the same thing, but just for the islands of Hawaii. So if you don't include shift geometry, the picture of the entire state of Hawaii is going to look a bit spread out because there are a couple small islands that are far away from each other. And so this will kind of shift them to look closer. That produces basically a better looking picture. So I'm going to run this line of code. This is the same thing as last time. I'm again using 2,000 people for one dot. And these lines of code are basically the same thing as well. I mostly just wanted to show two different examples in this video to show how to pull from different levels of geography. And also, I was trying to play around with a couple different examples that I could show. For example, in the last plot, we showed mostly green dots because it was South Florida and there were mostly Latinos in that area. And so Hawaii is another special case where there are mostly Asian people on the different islands and Native Hawaiians, obviously, on the different islands. And so you see more red dots than you would in most other states if I tried to plot them. So that's all I wanted to show in this video, and thank you guys for watching.